Hi there, my name is Dr. Tanya and today I'm here to tell you all about anal sex. Anal sex is a very taboo topic and a lot of us have a lot of questions that we don't know who to ask. So I'm going to address some of the most important questions and give you some general guidance on how to have safe and pleasurable anal sex, doctor approved. So, the first thing that you want to be absolutely sure on when you're having anal sex is, and this is the fundamental keyword here, is that you go slow. Go slow, relax, go slow, relax, go slow, relax, and communicate very effectively with your partner to see what's working for you and what's not. The reason why I insist so hard on the relaxation and the going slow is because if you really rush into it, there's a possibility that you might injure yourself, and if that's the case, you have to be prepared to go to the hospital and tell the doctor what was happening. I understand that can be very embarrassing. So in order to avoid that, the best technique is once again to go slow and communicate. Now, aside from the going slow and the communication, let's talk about another fundamental thing that you do need. You need a lot of lubricant. Now, lubricants essentially are things that can make it a little bit more moist. And because the anus doesn't have a lot of natural lubrication, you need more slip, essentially. And these lubricants provide a little bit of slip, so the penis can go inside a little bit easier, and you can have safe, comfortable anal sex. If you're using toys, that's also the same case. The other thing that you do need is condoms, and also dental dams. Now, you might be surprised, why do you need condoms for a sexual practice that does not have a risk of pregnancy very much? The reason why it's so important to have condoms in anal sex as well is because anal sex also can transmit sexually transmitted infections, and you want to avoid these at all costs. Not that they're not treatable, but why get an extra infection if you can avoid it? And the simple way to avoid STIs is to wear condoms. If you're going to have any kind of oral anal sex, you want to make sure you're using a dental dam. And if you're not able to find a dental dam on the market, you can make one from a condom itself. Just take the condom, snip off both ends, and then snip off one side of the condom. So, if you take the tube, cut one side of the tube. This will leave you with a square piece of latex, and that is your homemade DIY dental dam. Now that we've covered the things you need, let's cover an alternative thing that you may or may not need depending on the kind of sexual practice you're indulging in. Let's talk a little bit about toys. If you are going to be using toys for anal sex, you have to make sure that it's not just a random toy that's lying around at home. You have to use a very specific kind of toy for anal sex, and that is that you have to make sure that the toy you use has a flared bottom. What does this mean? It means that the toy should have a width. So at the end of the toy, there should be a wider section, and the wider section should be wider than the rest of the toy. What this means is that all toys should have a tapering end, which means they go like this, go tapering a little bit, and then flare out. This is very, very important because the anus naturally sucks things up. And in case it doesn't have this wider bottom that's wider than the width of the anus, you can actually have the toy go all the way up inside your anus. If you have a wider end, it'll get stuck and the toy will not be able to slide all the way up inside your body, and you can avoid another potentially embarrassing hospital visit. Now that we've covered these basics, let's talk about the actual process. For the process, we will need to make sure that there is consent on both sides, because that is the prime most important thing. After that, make sure you have the lubricant. Use the lubricant on the partner's anus or on your penis or on your toy or on your fingers, whatever you're planning to use. And cover whatever you're planning to use with a condom. If again this is going to be oral, make sure you're using a dental dam, and then gently ease the finger or the toy inside. It's not ideal to go with a thick penis or a thick toy right away, or actually just a penis right away, simply because the anus is quite tight the sphincter is very tight and you want to gently relax it instead of ramming things in there. And the reason behind that is that if you do ram things in there, you can damage the anus and that can lead to you not being able to control your poop. So, lubricate, condom, and then gently start with small toys or fingers. Warm up the anus, relax it. It's like doing stretching before you go for strenuous exercise. And only after that should you insert a larger toy or the penis. Make sure you go slow. And if your partner or if you're feeling any kind of pain, you must stop. Pain is a sign that something is not going well. Anal sex can be uncomfortable, but it should not be painful. And it should be pleasurable because that's the goal of sex. Healthy sexuality should always be pleasurable. So, once you have decided you're doing this, once you've communicated, you've lubed up, you've worn a condom, you're going slow, you're talking to your partner and finding out what's working for them and what's not, and then eventually you can get to the main act. Anal sex can be very, very pleasurable for people with a penis because it can internally stimulate the prostate. This is also called the P spot. And it is considered to be the equivalent of a G-spot, and a lot of people tend to really enjoy it. Anal orgasms can also be experienced by a lot of people, so if that's something you've experienced, that's great, and I hope you had a wonderful time with it. These are the most important things you should know before you attempt anal sex. I hope you have healthy, safe, consensual, and enjoyable sexual experience. Bye-bye.